अस्सलाम वालेकुम रहमतुल्लाहि व बरकातुहू। हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, होप यू ऑल आर फाइन एट होम। नाउ टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट विद द 30th लेक्चर ऑफ इंफॉर्मेशन टेक्नोलॉजी। दिस इज माय 30th लेक्चर ऑन एडवांस्ड जावास्क्रिप्ट ऑफ इंफॉर्मेशन टेक्नोलॉजी। टुडेज टॉपिक इज सेम, स्ट्रिंग ऑब्जेक्ट। इन लास्ट लेक्चर वी हैव ऑलरेडी स्टडीड अबाउट प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ स्ट्रिंग ऑब्जेक्ट एंड फोर मेथड्स ऑफ स्ट्रिंग ऑब्जेक्ट, दैट इज कैरेट मेथड, इंडेक्स ऑफ मेथड, लास्ट इंडेक्स ऑफ मेथड एंड सब एसटीआर मेथड। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट विद फ्यू मोस्ट मेथड्स ऑफ स्ट्रिंग ऑब्जेक्ट, दैट इज सब स्ट्रिंग, ट्रिम, टू लोअर केस एंड टू अपर केस मेथड। दीज आर फोर मेथड्स विच वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी टुडे। ओके, सो वी विल स्टार्ट विद द प्रीवियस टॉपिक, दैट इज सब एसटीआर, बिकॉज सब एसटीआर एंड सब स्ट्रिंग आर मोस्ट ऑफ द सिमिलर, राइट? देर इज अ सिमिलैरिटी बिटवीन सब एस टी आर एंड सब स्ट्रिंग मेथड। नाउ सी सब एस टी आर मेथड, वट वी डू विद सब एस टी आर मेथड, वी विल फेच द पार्ट ऑफ द स्ट्रिंग फ्रॉम द गिवन स्ट्रिंग, राइट? सो इन दिस सब एस टी आर मेथड देर आर टू पैरामीटर्स। फर्स्ट मेथड इज द स्टार्टिंग इंडेक्स नंबर एंड द सेकेंड पैरामीटर इज द लेंथ ऑफ द, और यू कैन से द कैरेक्टर नंबर्स, राइट? नंबर ऑफ कैरेक्टर्स विच यू वॉन्ट टू फेच from the given string. So there are two parameters. First one is the starting index number, starting position, or you can say the starting index number from where the string is to be fetched. Okay, and second parameter is the length of the string which you want to fetch, or you can say the number of characters from the string which you want to fetch. Got it? Now see, this is the example of substr method. Welcome students. Now here I am going to fetch the string from 0th position. What is the 0th position? W, right? This is the 0th position. So it start fetching the string from 0th position and it will fetch 7 characters. See here, 0th position, this is the 0th position, first position, second position, but it will fetch the number of character. This is the number of character, right? So from 0th position it will count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 7 characters, that is from W till E. It will fetch the string from W till E. This is my string, new string. Okay, so the first parameter is the position of this string, from where to begin. From here, this is the 0th position, so I want to fetch my string from here, and 7 characters I want to fetch, right? So this is the first character, second character, third character, fourth character, fifth character, sixth character and seventh character. So seventh character ends at E. So it will fetch the string welcome and it will display it as an output. This is the revision of previous lecture. Okay, now today's topic, we will start with today's topic, that is substring. What is the substring method will do? The substring method fetches the characters from a string between two specified index number. In previous substr method there are two parameters. First parameter was the starting index number, second parameter was the number of characters which you want to fetch. But here it is not like same, there are two parameters only, but the first parameter is the starting index number and the second parameter will be the last index number. Okay, but it does not include that last index number. It will display the string before the last index number. See the example, you will come to know. The number of characters to be fetched depends upon the starting index number and the last index number, but not included. The last index number is not included in the string, in the fetched string. Okay, if omitted, if last index number is omitted, then it will extract the rest of this string till the end of this string. Okay, now see substr. Instead of substr, we are writing substring. So here there are two parameters. First one is start and second one is end. This is the starting index number and this is the ending state index number. Okay, what is the start means? It is the starting position, or you can say the index number from where the fetching of new string starts. Okay, from this the new string starts. We will start fetching our new string from this index number. Okay, and the last index number is the last position, or you can see the index number of the character to fetch, but it is not included. If I write 0 to 4, so the fourth position is not included in the string. Okay, see the example, where str is equal to welcome students. This is my string. Okay, this is the given string. N is equal to str dot substring 0 to 4. That means it starts fetching the string from 0th position. From here it will start fetching the string, but it will fetch only 3 index number. It will fetch the list, or you can say the string, till 3rd index number, because 4th is not included in it, right? So 0th position, 1st position, 2nd position, 3rd position and 4th position. O is not included in that. Why? Because the last index number, it will fetch the string before the last index number. So the last index number is 4, 4th position is O, so it will fetch only till C. So the collected string will be WELC. Got it? So it will not include the last index number here. It will display the list, or it will display the characters before this last index number. I hope you are getting it. See the example, you will come to know. See here, students, this is my string and this is the output of the substring method. Now see the coding of this. This is the coding where I have taken one variable to save my string, that is str is equal to welcome students. This is the given string, document.write. Now here I have given one break and written the string is, I have displayed the string by using plus str. Here the string will be welcome students. It will display the given string on the screen. Okay, now after that, where n is equal to str dot substring, what is the substring method will do? There are two parameters. It will start fetching the new string from 0th position, that is W, okay, and it will fetch the string till 4th position, and 4th position is not included in the string, right? So it will fetch from W, 0th position, E, 1st position, 2nd position and 3rd position. O is not included in this. Got it? So it will fetch the string like WELC and it will display it as an output to this on the screen. See students here, right? 0th position, 1st position, 2nd position and 3rd position. 4th position is not included. Okay? See students, we will see the second example. This is the second example, okay. Now in this example, I have taken one string, that is welcome, hello, welcome to IT practicals, and I have fetched the string, that is welcome. Now see the coding, hello, welcome to IT practicals, this is my given string. I have displayed this string on the screen by using document.write method, okay. Now I have applied the substring method on this str.substring 7,13. Now see here, it will start fetching the string from 7th position, that is 0th position, 1st position, 2nd position, 3rd position, 4th position, 5th, 6th and 7th. At 7th position there is a W, right? It starts fetching the string from W position and till 13th position. This is the 7th position, 8th position, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. The 13th position is E. But it will fetch only till 12th position, because 13th position is not included in this, right? As I already explained you, that the last index number is not included in that string, fetched string, right? So it will fetch only WELCOM. So the output will be WELCOM only. Got it? Now see it again one more time. This is the substr method, where there are two parameters. First parameter is the starting index number from where the new string is going to be fetched. This is the starting number of that index number of that string, okay, which starts with 0, right? From 0th position start counting. The index number always starts with 0, okay? So it starts with 0, and this is the number of character which I want to fetch, the number of character, not the index number, okay? So it will count the characters from 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Got it? So it will display number of characters, that is 7 characters it will display on the screen. Got it? This is what? Sub-STR method. There are two parameters. First one is starting number and second one is the number of characters. Okay? And in sub-string method, there are two parameters. First one is the starting index number and second one is the last index number, where the last index number is not included in the new string. Getting it? If I write substring 0 to 4, that means it starts fetching this new string from 0th position, that is W, and it fetch only W, E, L, C. Why not O? Because it does not include this 4th position. Okay, it will fetch this string till 3rd position, 3rd index number only. Okay, now see next method, that is trim method. What is this trim method will do? Trim method is used to remove the byte space characters from the starting and the end of this string. It removes the byte spaces between the characters also if there are extra spaces given. Okay, if there is only one space given, doesn't matter, but if there are extra spaces given, then it will remove those extra spaces as well. Okay, it removes spaces, tabs, etc. Now this is the syntax of trim method, string dot trim. There is no parameter. Okay, you just need to write down the string name, okay, or you can say the variable name where your string is stored, and then dot trim. Trim is a method. There is no parameter of this trim. You can directly write string dot trim, all in small letters. Okay, now see the example. This is the example where str is equal to, there are spaces, right? Then welcome, then again long space, then students, and then again long space. So if I use trim method, it will remove all the extra spaces from the starting and from the ending of this string, as well as in between the characters also. If there are extra spaces given, then it will remove those extra spaces. It will allow only single space between the characters. Getting it? So here the value of n will be welcome student. No extra spaces are there in between. It will remove all these extra spaces from the starting of the characters and from the ending of the characters, and in between the characters also if there are extra spaces given. Okay, it allows only single space in between the characters. Now see the example of this. See students, now we will see the example of this. See, this is the example. Okay, hello, welcome to IT practicals. This is my string. Okay, and we will see the students. This is my string, that is where str is equal to. There is a gap between this first letter. Okay, before this first letter there is a gap. Then hello, again spaces, comma, again spaces, welcome to IT practicals, again spaces at the end, right? So if I use trim method, it will avoid using this, it will avoid taking these spaces in the starting, at the end, and in between the characters. Extra spaces, it will remove all these extra spaces from the string. Okay, now we will move to the next method, that is two lowercase method. What is this two lowercase method will do? The two lowercase method converts the entire string to lowercase. Okay, it will display your string into lowercase letters. Okay, this method does not affect any of the special characters or digits. This does not affect on special characters and digits. This only affect only on the alphabets. Okay, from A to Z, and it will convert all the letters into lowercase letter. See the example. This is the syntax: string dot to lowercase. There is again no parameter. Okay, then where str is equal to hello. Hello is in capital letter, then welcome, W is in capital letter, students, S is in capital letter. And if I apply two lowercase method to this string, then it will display hello, welcome, students, all letters in small letter. And the special character as it is, it will display the special character as it is. okay, it never affect on special characters. It only display, it only converts the letters from the uppercase to lowercase. Okay, see the example. This is the example where my string is hello, welcome to IT practicals. This is my string where hello is in capital letter, W is in capital letter, IT is in capital letter, right? But when I convert my string into lowercase letter, then it will display all letters in lowercase. See here. Now we will see the coding of this. See the source code. This is the source code. This is my string hello, welcome to IT practicals. This is my string. When I convert this string by using two lowercase letter, okay, see str dot two lowercase. This is the method which is used to convert all the letters in the string into lowercase. Okay, so it will display all the letters in the string into lowercase letters. See here, this is the example of two lowercase method. Got it? Now we will move to the uppercase method. Next method is two uppercase. These are opposite of each other. In two lowercase method, the letters will become in lowercase. But here, in two uppercase method, it will convert the letters into uppercase letter. Okay, the entire string will be converted into uppercase. Okay, see the syntax. This is the syntax: string dot to uppercase. Okay, there is no parameter required in this. So if my string is like this, by using two uppercase method, I will convert this whole string into uppercase letter. See here, this is the output of the string. Here hello is in capital letter, W is in capital letter, rest all the letters are in small letter. So it will convert all the letters into uppercase letter, and it will display the letters into uppercase on the screen. Hello, welcome student. This is the string which was like this before, right? And after using two uppercase method, it will be like this one. See here, hello, welcome students, all in capital letters. Okay, now we will see one example of this. See students, this is my string hello, welcome to IT practicals, and after conversion of this string, it will display all the letters in capital letters. See here, see the coding. See, this is the coding. Hello, welcome to IT practicals. This is my string, and after conversion of the string by using two uppercase method, will display all the letters in capital letter. I hope you all have understood all the methods. Okay students, so we will see, we have already studied about the property of string object, that is the length property of string object. This length property will return the number of characters in a string. Okay, this is the property which will return the number of characters in a string. Now we have seen one method of, we have seen few methods of string object, where the first method was caret method. What this caret method will do, it will return the number of characters at the specified position. Okay, the specified position is in number. Okay, you are supposed to write down the position in number, and the index number always starts with 0, right? So it starts with 0th position, it starts counting with 0th position. Now second method is index of. This index of method will return the index number of the first occurrence of a specified character. Okay, in this index of method, there is a parameter which is the parameter is the character name. Okay, it is a character, and it will find that character, the first, it will find the first occurrence of that character, and it will return the number of position to you. If that character is not present in the string, then it will return -1 as an output. Okay, last index of means it will start searching the character from the last position of the string. Okay, in reverse order it starts searching, and it will search the last index of, it will search the last position of the specified character in the given string. Again, if the character is not present in the string, it will return -1 as an output. Substr method In this sub-STR method, there are two parameters. First parameter is what? The starting index number to fetch the new string, and second parameter is the number of characters which you want to fetch. Okay, so this sub-STR method is used to fetch the string from the given string. Okay, a new string will come after fetching the previous string. Okay, and substring method will do, there are two parameters. First one is the starting index number, second one is the ending index number, and that last index number is not included as a string. Okay, then trim, what trim will do, it will remove all these spaces from the both sides. Okay, two lowercase will do. This method is used to convert all the string into lowercase letter. To uppercase means it will convert all the string into uppercase letter. Okay, so here we end with this string object. Okay, so all these are the property and methods of string object. You are supposed to practice the programs which I have already explained you in detail. Okay, you just see, practice it. If you have any doubt, you can make a note. Whenever we will open the college, you just come and clear your doubt there. Okay, thank you so much. We will stop here only.